Strike with thunder and retrieve Mercy's shield from the stag chargers and Mercy's sword from the Strangler Goblins. You fight as fiercely as King Artorius once did. Restore the Shrine to Mercy. Your sharp eyes will see a portal appear leading beneath the waves. Do not fear. The portal will ensure you can breathe beneath Nimue. I will meet you below to show you the path to the final shrine. Restore the Shrine to Mercy, then journey beneath the waves of Nimue. Find me below to begin the most dangerous part of your quest. Restore the Shrine to Mercy, then journey beneath the waves of Nimue. Find me below to begin the most dangerous part of your quest.
You restore the Shrine to Mercy of a gentle rain from above upon the place beneath on both givers and takers. You hear the crash of waves and see a portal rising up to reveal the way below.
The Pendragon's foul magic even reaches under the lake's surface, this most sacred of places. He has done much harm to Avalon. The last shrine is located far beneath Castle Avalon. There is no way to reach it from above without facing the Pendragon. And he would kill you without the Sword of Kings. We will be sly and sneak you in from below. We must rebuild the broken teleporter arch. Defeat the Drowned Knight for the first piece of the teleporter arch.